Hey, this is Jenny Jones. Wanted to give you a quick look inside. I think people have been asking, hey, I want to know what it looks like. And this is a typical flow that I just built inside of VBOUT. And again, they have the triggers, which you always start with a trigger, right? And then you have an action, right? I want something trigger, something, then I want an action to happen. And I'm showing you both the triggers and action because I'm going to show you the same for in charge too. There's things I like about in charge. There's things I love about VBOUT. There's things I love about in charge, and there's things I like about VBOUT. So start with a simple trigger here. The trigger is open email. So we had a customer that opened an email. What I wanted to do is, oh, they finally opened the email, right? I want to add them to this tag over here. And this tag is, it can be anything like, hey, open email user, now they're interested, or interested tag, right? And then I want them to sit maybe for 2 days, but I do want to show you something. So this is the tag. I think tags pretty much work for most of all the types of mail flow type of software that's out there, your ConvertKits, things of that nature. But what I wanted to show you, which was interesting, there's two things I want to show you compared to the same flow I set up in InCharge. I'm going to show you InCharge, and then I'm going to show you VBOT's then in charges next. So you add the tag. So we got four things here. I want to add the tag. As soon as it opens, the action is I want to add the tag. I want to add a delay of, I think, 2 days, and I put in there. And then I want to send out another email. So this is just a simple setup here. But what I wanted to show you was this is what you get when you click on delay. Look at the customization you get for delay. Do I want to delay 2 days, 3 hours, or 5 minutes? Do I want it to delay for a specific day, or do I want to execute it on the following days? Do not send this out on a Sunday, do not send this out on a Saturday, but only send it out on Fridays, because I want the greeting to say, hey, happy Friday, what have you, what, you know. And so you can have an execute time, you can have an end time. This is the customization that you get. So I want you to keep that in mind, because I am going to show you in charge next, but I want to keep the videos relatively short. So we're going to close it out with that. Another thing I want to show you, because this is one video, and I'm going to show you in charge, same setup, using these same four, using the one trigger and the four actions, the three actions that follow. So this is I wanted to send an email. So what you're going to get in email is you're going to get, hey, choose an automation that's already set up, right? Once they get that email, they can go through that, or create another in automation on the fly. Allow multiple entries for the same contact, or allow that contact to only hit this entry once. If they've already been down this path before, there's no need to send them down it again. So you can just say, hey, I want them to either come in several times, or I just want them to hit it once. And then, so that's what I wanted you to see, these two actions. I wanted you to see the add delay, and I wanted you to see the send email, right? Take another look at that. You can go into an automated series that you already set up, or you can create one on the fly, right? So I wanted you to see that, and I wanted you to see the delay and the customization of what I can do, a specific date and time, right? And I just wanted you to see that. And this is just a simple automation. All right, see you in the next one for in charge. Thanks.